Good morning. How low can you go? Today we're at Jeremiah chapter 7, verses 28 through 31. So you shall say to them, this is a nation that does not obey the voice of the Lord their God, nor receive correction. Truth has perished and has been cut off from their mouth. Cut off your hair and cast it away, and take up a lamentation on the desolate heights. For the Lord has rejected and forsaken the generation of his wrath. For the children of Judah have done evil in my sight, says the Lord. They have set their abominations in the house which is called by my name to pollute it. And they have built the high places of Tophet, which is in the valley of the son of Hinnom, to burn their sons and their daughters in the fire, which I did not command, nor did it come into my heart. How low can you go? You can sacrifice your children to false gods. Most of you can flip to the back of your Bible and find some maps there. Mine has quite an interesting map. By the way, I hope that when you join me for these short devotionals, you do have your Bible in your hand and you're reading the text. But take a look at those maps and you'll likely find a map of Jerusalem. You see the Temple Mount on the upper right and the Kidron Valley running roughly north-south along the right. And at the south side of the city, not far outside the wall, you see the Hinnom Valley running east-west and then kind of north along the left. The Hinnom Valley is where the kings of Judah sacrificed their children to Baal and to Molech. You can read about that in a variety of places in your Bible. Solomon introduced the worship of Molech, and it was quite prominent during the reigns of Ahaz and Manasseh. In one historical record from the city of Carthage, the child would be placed on the arms of the statue, and then it would tumble off down this chute into the fire at the base of the statue. It's little wonder that Hinnom and Tophet were associated with hell. And of course, we know that not long later, in the time of Jesus, Gehenna, that was considered to be the valley where they would throw the burning refuse, the town dump, so to speak. King Josiah, I believe, tried to make it the town dump to disassociate people. They didn't want to continue to worship Molech there because the place had been desecrated by their garbage. Are we sacrificing our children today? Now, of course, there's the A word, but there's other ways we sacrifice our children too, isn't there? When we teach our children deranged views of human sexuality and sexual practices, it can't help but warp the child. Is that like sacrificing your kid to Molech? In fact, I think the lowest thing that can happen is when an adult corrupts the feelings and desires of a small child. I don't know what would be more corrupt than that. That's worse than bestiality. Where are the protectors? Whoever made the state the protector of our children? You know that all of us as Christians are charged to protect the weak? But we don't protect the weak because we ourselves are corrupted. We practically lock our aged people into retirement homes where they die because of government rules. Don't imagine that our morality as a culture today is higher than those who burned their children in the valley of the son of Hinnom. And on that note, let's pray. Dear Father in heaven, we do not realize how corrupt the world that we're living in is, but corrupt indeed is the situation. Help us, Lord, to be right. Help us to protect young children and aged people and all who are weak and need protection. Help us to have wisdom, Lord, to know how to interact with these morally corrupt times in which we are. Help us to be Christians, lights of unselfishness in a time of self-service. Help your church, Lord, to rise above the common approaches. We pray that you will help our eyes to be open and give us insight for how we can rightly approach these things and do it right. Thank you for hearing our prayer, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Solemn times call for surrendered hearts. May your heart be fully surrendered to Jesus this day.